Hello everyone, welcome back to another session in Dentistry and More. Today we have a very important topic in fixed partial denture, that is pontics. So this will be dealt in two sessions. This session is highlighting on the various designs, various classification and its advantages and disadvantages. Next session is about the factors to be considered when designing a pontic. So it's a very commonly asked essay question. So all of us know fixed partial denture, that is FPD. It's a classic FPD where the one tooth is replaced with the help of two supported teeth on either side. This is a classic example of FPD. So let's see what are the basic components of a FPD. So FPD as pontic, which is a tooth to be replaced, which is present in the edentulous area, and two artificial teeth, which is coming as a joint unit along with the pontic. They are known as retainer. This is a classic example. So we have a retainer on either side, and there is something known as connector, which connects the pontic and retainer. And abutment are natural teeth or RCT treated teeth, which is present adjacent to the edentulous space, which receives retainers. So these are the four components of a fixed partial denture. Today we are going to learn about the pontic in detail. As per definition, GPT 8, pontic is an artificial tooth on a fixed dental processes that replaces a missing natural tooth, restores its function, and usually fills the space previously occupied by the clinical crown. Now we directly jump to our classification, that is classification based on shape of surface contacting the ridge. So we have basically sanitary pontic, then we have modified sanitary pontic, then spheroidal pontic, then we have saddle shape pontic, then we have ridge lap pontic, then modified ridge lap, and we also have ovate pontic. So this is based on the shape of surface contacting the ridge. Okay, contacting ridge. The next classification, according to Rosenstiel, depending on the mucosal contact, that is with mucosal contact and without mucosal contact. So the sanitary and modified sanitary, that is classified under no mucosal contact, which doesn't have any contact with the gums. And the other are ridge lap, modified ridge lap, conical and ovate. So they comes under mucosal contact category, which contacts the ridge. And also we have another classification based on the material, that is metal and porcelain veneered, metal and resin veneered, all metal and all ceramic. So it is a basic classification of pontics. So the next classification is based on fabrication. Okay, based on fabrication. So that is custom made and pre-fabricated. In pre-fabricated, we have true pontic, interchangeable facing, sanitary pontic, pin facing, modified pin facing, reverse pin facing, harmony pontic, porcelain fused to metal, pre-fabricated, custom modified pontic. Now we have the basic selection criteria or the factors involved in anterior and posterior pontic. So we need to think about aesthetics and oral hygiene with respect to the anterior and posterior pontic. So in anterior pontics, a correctly placed anterior pontics should have following things, that is all surface should be convex and smoothly and properly finished, and contact with labial mucosa should be minimal, that is a pinpoint contact, and pressure free, that is lap facing, that is pinpoint contact and pressure free, which is lap facing, and the lingual contour should be in harmony with the adjacent teeth or pontics. Whereas a posterior pontic design should have all surfaces in convex manner, smooth and properly finished, just like anterior. So the contact with buccal slopes should be minimal, that is pinpoint, and it is modified ridge lap. Modified ridge lap. Okay, here it is just lap facing. So the pressure free, here we use modified ridge lap. An occlusal table must be in functional harmony with the occlusion of all of the teeth. Buccal and lingual shunting mechanism should conform to those of the adjacent teeth. And the overall length of buccal surface should be equal to that of the adjacent abutment or pontics. Now let's see one by one, that is a prefabricated pontic facing. These are commercially available porcelain pontics which can be altered by the dentist and reglazed if necessary. The first one is true pontic. So true pontic, there will be a horizontal tubular slot in the center of the lingual surface of facing. You can see a horizontal tubular slot in the center of the lingual surface. Okay, so slot in the center of lingual surface. The second one is interchangeable facing. Interchangeable facing or flat back facing. So it is manufactured with a vertical slot running down the flat lingual surface. Okay, so this facing is retained with a lug which engages the retention slot. So you can see the picture here, the vertical slot which is running down the flat lingual surface. Okay, and it is retained with a lug which engages the retention slot. The third one is the sanitary facing. So always draw picture when you write the answer for pontics, because it's very confusing, horizontal, vertical and all. So sanitary facing, flat occlusal surface and a slot on the proximal surface. Okay, you can see the picture. And this slot on the proximal surface to fit into the metal projections made in the FPD. So this slot will receive the pins from the FPD. Now we have the fourth one, that is pin facing pontic. So pin facing pontic, which is a flat lingual facing with two horizontal pins for retention. The pins are already there in the pontic. So that is pin facing. Then we have modified pin facing. So there is slight difference between modified pin facing and normal pin facing. In modified, the facing is modified by adding porcelain to the lingual gingival area of pin facing. You can see a lingual gingival area addition of a porcelain when comparing to the previous pin facing. Additional gingival part is there, that is a modified pin facing. The next one is reverse pin facing. So this is different one, actually it is reverse pin facing. The porcelain denture teeth can be modified to be used as a bridge facing. Porcelain is added to the gingival end of the facing and multiple precision pin holes are drilled into the lingual surface. Okay, so this is reverse pin facing. Actually there is no pins are there, instead there is holes present for retention. So porcelain denture teeth can be modified. Okay, so how do we modify? The porcelain is added to the gingival end of the facing and precision pin holes. So the picture here, you can see there is lots of holes which is present, unlike the pin facing which has projections having holes to receive the pins. Okay, next we have harmony facing. So harmony facing is nothing but a facing is supplied with an uncontoured porcelain gingival surface and usually two retentive pins on the flat lingual side. That is harmony facing, which has got two pins on the lingual side and uncontoured porcelain gingival surface which can be contoured by the dentist. Then we have the porcelain fused to metal facing. Facing consists of a metal core over which porcelain is fused. And the last one is pontips. Pontips is a convex gingival surface having pinpoint tissue contact and attached to the backing occlusally with the retentive pins. That is pontips. Now let's see what is sanitary or hygienic pontic. You can see the picture here. the zero tissue contact, this is having no tissue contact, occlusal gingival thickness should be at least 3 mm, and this is convex mesiodistally and faciolingually. Space beneath the pontic is 2 mm or 3 mm. You can see the space between the gingiva and the lower part of pontic, and there will be adequate space for cleaning. That is the most important. So that is why it got this name. This has got cleaning space between the ridge and pontic. Whereas a modified sanitary pontic, when this becomes modified, what happens is this gingival portion is shaped like a concave archway mesiodistally between the retainers and convex faciolingually. So there is a change in the shape. That is, mesiodistally it becomes concave. Okay, before it was just convex. So this allows, there is a modified sanitary pontic which is having mesiodistal concavity, allows increased connector size while decreasing the stress which is concentrated in the pontic and connectors. That is a advantage, okay, making it concave mesiodistally. And this is recommended basically for the mandibular posteriors where we have complaints of foot lodgement. Okay, so you can see the picture here. This is a sanitary pontic and this is modified sanitary pontic. Now we have the saddle pontic or ridge lap pontic. So the saddle pontic has a concave fitting surface that overlaps the residual ridge bucko lingually. Okay, this stimulates the contours and emergence profile of the missing tooth on both sides of the residual ridge. So it gives a good aesthetic appearance, that is, it simulates the contours and emergence profile of the missing tooth on both sides. Okay, so this is a fitting surface which is concave and it overlaps the residual ridge bucco lingually. You can see the picture here, buccal and lingual. But the main problem with this saddle or ridge lap pontic is the concave gingival margin of the pontic is not accessible. Okay, it is not accessible for cleaning with dental floss. We just cannot do the cleaning, so there will be plaque accumulation and ultimately tissue inflammation. So that is a problem with this plaque and tissue inflammation. Whereas in modified ridge lap pontic, the changes in design is the modified ridge lap pontic combines the best features of the hygienic and the saddle pontic design. So this overlaps the residual ridge on the facial to achieve the appearance of a tooth emerging from the gingiva, but it remains clear of the ridge on the lingual side. So cleaning is also done. So you can see the picture here. On the facial side, it overlaps the residual ridge, so we get a good aesthetic appearance because it looks like emerging from the gingiva, and it remains clear. So the lingual part is free, so we can easily clean this. So there is no plaque accumulation and tissue inflammation. So this is modified ridge lap pontic. Before the saddle or ridge lap, it has got this plaque accumulation and tissue inflammation problem. So this is modified ridge lap. So the tissue contact should resemble a letter of T, whose vertical arm, this is a vertical arm, ends at the crest of the ridge. You can see here. So the ridge contact should be up to the midline of the edentulous ridge. So most common pontic form used in areas of high visibility, such as maxillary and mandibular anterior and maxillary premolars and maybe first molars. So the vertical arm should end at the crest of the ridge, then the ridge contact should be up to the midline of the edentulous ridge. Now we have another one, that is a conical pontic. Conical pontic. So in conical pontic, as the name suggests, it is egg-shaped or bullet-shaped, egg-shaped or bullet-shaped or heart-shaped. So this is convex with only one point of contact at the center of the residual ridge. And this is, you can see the picture here, this is almost like an egg. We can say it is a heart or bullet. So it is recommended for the replacement of mandibular posterior teeth where aesthetics is a lesser concern. So the facial and lingual contours are dependent on the width of the residual ridge. So a knife-edged residual ridge requires a flatter contour pontic with a narrow tissue contact. So this type of design may be unsuitable for broad residual ridge. It is always suitable for knife-edged ridge, because it is not suitable for broad, because the emergence profile associated with the small tissue contact point may create areas of foot entrapment. So to avoid foot entrapment in knife-edged ridge, always use conical pontic. Now we have the next one, that is ovate pontic. So ovate pontic is most aesthetically appealing. Its convex tissue surface resides in a soft tissue depression or hollow in the residual ridge, which makes it appear that a tooth is literally emerging from the gingiva. So that is very aesthetically appealing, because it looks like it is emerging from the socket, because it is convex tissue surface which goes into the depression. So socket preservation techniques should be performed at the time of extraction to create the tissue recess from which the ovate pontic form will emerge. For a pre-existing residual ridge, soft tissue surgical augmentation is typically required, because usually it will be a flat, so we need a socket type, then only this ovate pontic will fit into the socket. So surgical augmentation is required. When an adequate volume of ridge tissue is established, a socket depression is sculpted into the ridge with surgical diamond or electrosurgery. So we need to create a depression in the socket, then only this ovate pontic can be placed. So the advantage is not susceptible to any foot impaction. It has broad convex geometry and it is accessible to dental floors, but the problem is cost and the surgical tissue management. So that is all about various pontics. So we learned about sanitary or hygienic, then the saddle or ridge lap, then the modified ridge lap, then the conical, then ovate. And we also learned about prefabricated pontic facing, which is a facing. This is actual pontic. Okay, there is a difference between true pontic and facing. So in facing, we learned about true pontic, interchangeable facing or flat pack facing pontic, sanitary facing, pin facing, modified pin facing, reverse pin facing, then harmony facing, porcelain fused metal facing, pont tips. So those facing and the true pontics. So hope you understood this. So always draw pictures while writing the pontic design. So next session is about the factors, the biological, aesthetical and mechanical factors to be considered when designing a pontic. So I'll come up with that topic. Thank you.